mentioned the birds. So birds are the most visible residents here. So you see them floating on open water, resting and feeding on mudflats or soaring overhead. So most of these birds, this bay is their winter home or a stopover during their migration. There are 225 different species of birds recorded here so far. There are four broad migratory flyways in the USA: Pacific, Central, Mississippi, and Atlantic. So here in California, we are on the Pacific Flyway. So these flyways are the combination of different parallel and overlapping routes that followed by different flocks of birds. So birds have an amazing capability to follow the same route year after year. They use Earth's magnetic field to do it. So scientists are really unsure how birds exactly do it. They think birds can recognize the landmarks, and they look for the position of sun and stars. And birds' individual organs such as eyes, beak, nose, and ears also contributing to their remarkable navigational capability. A bird's eye interact with its brain in a region called cluster N, and that's how they determine the direction of north. Some researchers think that birds can smell its way across the flyway. The trigeminal nerve, which connects bird's beak to its brain, which is also helping them to determine the exact location and to determine the strength of Earth's magnetic field. So which is stronger at the poles and weaker at the equator. And the neuron concentrations, the iron concentrations in the neurons of bird's inner ear, which is also helping them in the direction determination. So all together is their internal global positioning system, GPS. So now let's talk about migration. So, do anyone wants to answer why these birds migrate? To feed and breed, they migrate. Yeah. So during fall season and winter season, so many birds are coming here from northern Canada and Alaska to feed and breed.
I wanna challenge these college students to why would they not feed in Alaska or other parts? Why do they have to come here?
The fish, maybe?
Don't they have fish in Alaska?
Maybe the source is not as much during a certain
season.
Yeah.
What, do all birds eat fish? I'm torturing you guys.
Some birds eat rodents. Like
right? Those. Some birds eat rodents. What about that bird like in her picture she's got there, that little bird right there?
Is that a type of fish?
No, this is actually a type of warbler, but what do you suppose it might eat?
Insects.
So what do you suppose is going on up in the north that would require them
to migrate? I guess the weather, the season, I don't know if they eat mosquitoes, but I know that the mosquitoes will freeze off during the winter time, or necessarily in Alaska, if it's cold. And if they migrate, then they'll get fresh insects.
Right, so they have to follow the food supply, right? Sorry.
And so, as he said, these places become too cold and inhabitable during fall season. So, during spring season, they go back. So, because the competition for food and space are substantially lower there. So, usually spring migrations are faster than fall migrations because of the impetus to breed. And some birds can fly 95 hours non-stop. So the average distances traveled can be vary from 25 miles to 250 miles in a day. So larger amounts of energy is needed for migratory flying. So prior to migration, these birds rest and eat for 10 to 20 days, and they increase their body fat to 30 to 50%. And wetlands along the migration route are their stopping points during the migration. So when when wetlands are lost to development, these birds have to fly longer distances to feed themselves. So they go undernourished and they get diseases. So some birds, such as sandpipers, are genetically programmed to only feed from certain feeding grounds. So when that particular wetland lost to development, they cannot survive to fly further. Normally, a common sandpiper can survive up to 12 years in the wild. So, Upper Newport Bay is one of the very important estuaries on the Southern California coast, so we all have to chip in to protect it. Now let's talk about birds' beak adaptations. So long, broad beak these kind of beak are for herons, egrets, and kingfishers. So this is to spear the fish or prey. And this one for ducks and coots to stay in the water. So we have you can see this one. So there is wing demonstration of a blue heron, which is coming under this one. So and we have a mallard duck wing demonstration here. And so long-billed curlew and some other short birds, and they have long beak for probing food in mudflats. So we have some short bird pictures here. So they are probing for food on mudflats. So they have different beak lengths, so they can probe mud without any competition. And here we have sharp hooked beak for tearing meat. So for hawk, harrier, osprey, eagle, they are coming under this one. And slim sharp beak for catching insects. So California gnatcatcher, warbler, wren. And for hummingbirds, they have tubular beak and that act as straw. It resembles a straw, so they can suck nectar from the flowers. So here we have pelican. So pelicans have pouched beak, and cormorants also have. They have long hook beak for catching fish. So pelicans can hold 3 gallons of water in their pouch. And here we have so many white pelicans, but we don't have very many brown pelicans because they are the victims of DDT pesticides. And strong sharp beak for pecking through wood. And yeah, so sparrows and finches have this kind of beak.
Can you repeat the one that was extinct because of the what?
DDT. DDT pesticide.
It's not extinct, but their numbers are low, yeah. And they're still
now
concerned.
Endangered, I guess, species.
And they are coming under endangered, but they are now surviving.
Okay,
yeah. Thank you. And feet adaptations. And here on Upper Newport Bay, we have 6 habitats. So you can see all the birds coming under all these 6 habitats. So first habitat is open water habitat, mud flats, then salt marsh and open water marsh, uplands and riparian. So, thank you for listening to me. Do you have any questions? And we have some birds, a bunch of birds down there. So we have some of them put on the binoculars for you. So you can have a look.
I have a
question. What are the last two wings?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, this one, this is a barn owl. No.
Great horned owl.
Yeah, sorry. Great horned owl. And this is from red winged hawk.
Red tailed hawk.
Red hawk. Red tailed hawk. You can.
What birds would we commonly see right now?
There is a list that we did end of last year. Well, this is a bird count done by Sage and Audubon Society.
That's so, lots and lots of different types of birds. So you might ask your trail guide to stop and point out some specific species to you, but Howard there might have a red-tailed hawk in the scope right now.
Do you want to have this one?
Yeah.